This video is about using a network analyzer to test a low-pass filter. The first thing I'm going to do is to normalize the transmission here. This is measurement one. I go over to the calibrate, then push the normalize button. This adjusts the gain to compensate for any cable loss or variations. Then I unscrew the two cables from each other and hit measure two. Then I go to reflection, which puts me on reflection, I should say. And then we hit calibrate again. Now the unit is ready to test. Now I'm going to reach over and get one of the devices to test here. This is a TLF-150 low-pass filter, and we're going to hook it up here. Sorry about having my hands in the way there, but I don't think you need to see how to screw this together. And as you see, we have the return loss, and now I've clicked over to measurement one, which is a forward loss. Well, I placed a few markers on the screen here. See 50 megahertz over here at number one. Number two is 140 megahertz. That's just below the 2 meter band. And 150, which is number three, I think I'll change that to 175, well, 174. Let's put it there to show the corner frequency of this particular filter. And then right now we're at the same frequency on number four, so we're going to change that to 222 megahertz, which is the lower edge of the 222 megahertz amateur radio band. So you can see that we're at 0.05, 0.1, 0.15, and about 11 dB respectively for those four markers. So we do have some reduction at 220 of any garbage that might be coming out of a 150 meg or 2 meter amateur transmitter. And I can now change this thing to 40 dB, the 40 dB point. And that is now at 300.17. So that's the 40 dB, and it's from that, from 300 to 550. But of course, looking at the return loss here, we look at number two here, and it's down at 20, and number three, and that's fine, and it's down at 20 there at 174, as well as at 50. So over that whole range, we're doing pretty good, certainly usable. But we can also, if we want to, use this at the edge of the actual range that it is achieving here. So let me adjust this a little bit. Sorry for the arm in the way there. At the 14 dB point, which is 1.5 to 1, still usable, and gets us the ability to go up to 178.8, so almost to 179 megahertz if we need to use it there. The filters listed here can be somewhat customized when you order them. Just indicate what your operating frequency is, that is a pass frequency, and what frequencies you want to reject, that is the notch frequencies. These particular units can be adjusted somewhat. So contact the factory and give them the specs on pass and reject frequencies that you need. So in summary, normalize the network analyzer transmission with the test cables connected together. Disconnect the cables, an open circuit in other words. Normalize the network analyzer reflection port with the test cables open. Connect the test device between the cables. Once you get the result, use markers to determine performance at the desired frequencies and any other frequencies that you might want to look at. For VHF low-pass filters, Telewave can optimize loss at the pass and reject frequency if you provide us with your desired operating and rejection frequencies.